Today we're going to talk about the micro switch. This is a simpler form of a switch. All you have to do to actuate it is have it click down and it'll create a circuit between this lead and this lead. So that's what the leads look like. We have red on one side and then we have black on the other. In a moment I'll show you how to connect it to the RADS board. Okay, here's the RADS board. We have a bunch of N-stop connectors here. I'm going to outline them real quick for you. We have the X-min, we have the Y-min, we have the Z-min, then we have the X-max, the Y-max, and the Z-max. Now, the first row of pins for all of them right here is 3.3 volts. The next row over is ground, and the very last row is signal. So to connect this, what we're going to do is we're going to connect the black wire to ground for Z-min, and then we're going to connect the red wire to signal for Z-min. And in a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB connector to the computer and load the firmware. Okay, to connect, we need to connect the USB serial for the small side. So this goes right next to the programming port within it, right next to the power for the 12 volts on the Arduino Duo. And the other end goes into the computer, and you'll hear a beep. And keep in mind that you don't want to touch this area once it's been energized. In a moment, I'll load the firmware. Okay, we're in the folder for Marlin Bugfix 2.0x. So we're going to open that up. We're going to go into the Marlin folder. We're going to go into the source folder. And we're going to go into the core folder. Now we're going to open up boards.h. And what we're looking for, we're going to search on RADS because that's the name of our board. And we found it here. So what we want to do is copy out the name board_RADS and close out of this. Then we're going to go back a directory. And in the Marlin directory, we're going to open up marlin.ino. Okay, now there's three tabs. There's the Marlin, configuration.h, and configuration_adv.h, which is configuration_advanced.h. So we want the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And what we're going to do is we're going to change board_ramps_14_EFB to what we just copied from the board_RADS in boards.h. And then we're going to look for the end stop for end stops. And we're going to scroll down and take a look. So Z-min is enabled, so we're good there. And I believe we don't need to invert in this case, so we're also good there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the tools and I'm going to check to see what we have for our board, which we have Arduino Duo for the programming port. So we're good there. And then we have the programming port selected for COM3. So all we have to do is compile and upload. And in a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how to test the N-stop micro switch. Okay, we're going to open up the Pronterface.exe. We're going to connect to the device and we're going to type M119 to find the status of the N-stops. Right now it says Zeeman is open, so I'm going to actuate it with my finger. I'm going to type M119 again and press enter. And it says triggered. So I'm going to let my fingers go. Now I'm going to do M119 again to see what the status is. And it says open. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.